Well, I say to those people that this, they know full well, this has been a divisive issue, not just for the time of our government, some 23 months today since we were sworn in, but it was a divisive issue well before the last election, and in fact, the one before that. So this is no surprise to business, the business community, to labor unions, to Indigenous groups, to people sitting at in coffee shops today here in Vancouver or throughout British Columbia. This is an issue that's divided communities, it's divided families. I'm not oblivious to that. My responsibility, however, is to look at what is the consequence of a catastrophic event as a result of this decision. And I think even those who support the pipeline would want me to continue to fight hard to make sure that the marine response plan of the federal government is adequate to meet the needs of a catastrophic spill. We've identified gaps in the ocean protection plan. We've raised those with the federal government. We'll continue to do that. But that's not in the context of this project. It's in the context of what's the right thing for the government of BC to do. And I think there's unanimous support for making sure that we are prepared for a terrible event. The best thing we can do is make sure that the federal government steps up and does what they said they will do, and be then in a position to fill those gaps if need be. But it's the federal government's project. It's the federal government that's responsible for our marine environment. If they're not prepared to protect it, we certainly will. But the best way forward is for us to continue to work hard. I raised it again with the Prime Minister today. I got assurances from him that the commitment from the federal government remains firm. I say you need to double down on that. We'll see how that goes in the months ahead.